summer music camp. Before we get started here today, I just wanted to let you know what a great group of students we have this year. As a volunteer, not an instructor, I was free to go around and observe what they were doing in all their little master classes and the full ensemble, and even got roped into to helping play with the full ensemble to sit next to some of them. And I love seeing them all engaged in what the instructors were doing and interested in improving their skills. That's what this is all about, learning new things. So I'm pretty sure I can speak for the entire staff in saying that everybody on this stage has definitely improved in just this past week. I think many of them were a little bit shocked by the music they saw on Monday and wondered how they would be able to perform it by Friday. But here they are, and I think they will rise to the challenge by the time we're playing. They've been sounding great. And I think they're confident in that assessment. So thank you, parents, grandparents, and other loved ones for making music a priority in your students' lives. Confident that they'll carry this experience with them even into adulthood. So before you get to hear a portion of what they've been working on this week, I'd like to brag about the caliber of the staff that have been working with them. As you can see in the program, all of our instructors work with young students to some degree, and I've seen them do such a great job this week. You may notice that their job isn't even quite done. They're actually sitting up here now playing alongside their students. You might even hear some calling out notes or positions. I don't know. We'll find out what happens. So if you're wondering why some of these middle schoolers look a little too old to be in this camp, that's hopefully what's going on there. And we had two excellent clinicians working with us this week. First is Dr. Andy Pettis, who you'll see is filling out our low read section on Barry. He's originally from Alabama, where he received degrees in music education and mathematics from the only university there that matters, Roll Tide. He then got his Master of Music and Doctor of Musical Arts from the University of Miami and Minnesota, respectively. Currently, he's the Director of Instrumental Music at Anderson University and the conductor of the Anderson Symphony Orchestra. When not involved in music, Dr. Pettis is an avid tennis player and enjoys time with his wife, Ashley, and children. Before coming to Anderson, he was director of bands at Hillcrest High School in Tuscaloosa, Alabama, which leads us to our next clinician, who will be conducting for us this evening. Dr. Leslie Walker was the director of bands at Hillcrest and Duncanville Middle Schools in Tuscaloosa for many years, and led her band to more awards and recognitions than we have time to fully list out. But suffice it to say that her band's excellence was well known throughout the state. She has personally received much recognition for her work, and continues to be invited as a guest conductor for clinics, competitions, and camps just like this one. She holds a Bachelor of Music degree from Appalachian State and a Master of Music Education and Doctorate in Education from the University of Alabama, Roll Tide again. Aside from her excellence in teaching middle school band, she is the proud mother of two children, Adrian, who is a saxophonist with the U.S. Navy Band, and Jared, a hornist with the U.S. Air Force Academy Band. She now lives in Asheville, North Carolina. We're so pleased to have her there here this year. So hopefully this gives you a small picture of who has been working with your kids this week. And I hope they've come home talking about what their instructors have been doing with them. We'll be posting some videos on YouTube of what they've been doing in the master classes and things like that on our Facebook and YouTube channel if you want to check that out later this week or next week. So I hope they took a good advantage of the time and knowledge that these folks have offered them. And more importantly, I hope that they've had fun making music and learning new things. But enough from me. Please enjoy Dr. Leslie Walker with our summer music camp staff and students.
Thank you. very, very exciting time for me. Being retired now, I don't get to get in front of groups every day anymore, and it's a real treat when I do. And these kids are fantastic. They really have worked very hard this week, and we've enjoyed ourselves so much. That was Winchester March, which is a very kind of a staple of some of the band literature now. We're going to switch gears just a little bit and play something that is called Flight of the Thunderbird. And I was looking up what a Thunderbird is, and it's really a mythical bird, the North American Indians. And it's supposed to be a bird that provides water, the rain, so crops will grow, and the lightning shoots out of its mouth, and when it flaps its wings, that's thunder. Well, I thought, well, that's pretty neat, and that's a good name for the tune. Then I found out that the composer actually, he asked his kids in his band what it should be called, and they said, how about the Flight of the Thunderbird, because the Thunderbird is our school mascot. So it had nothing to do really with the Thunderbird bird. So anyway, I hope you enjoy Flight of the Thunderbird.
Thank you.
inches taller to be able to see how to turn the microphone off and on. This next piece, to me, I think is very beautiful. First off, Flight of the Thunderbird is just one of my very favorites. And boy, didn't they play great. It takes a lot of guts to stand in front of an audience like that and play. She did such a beautiful job. And percussion, and you know what? I forgot to say something about percussion. Percussion, raise your arms up in the air. They had really good stuff to play there. Weren't they terrific? Now, this next piece of music is very different from what we just played. It's called the Rowan tree, and the Rowan tree is a tree that I don't know that it grows in the United States. I think it's more it grows in China, that sort of thing. It's from the rose family, and it has bright red berries. And it's supposed to be, I even wrote it down. It's supposed to be a magical tree to prevent travelers from getting lost. That's one thing that it does. And it also, let's see. It is known as the tree of life, and it symbolizes courage, wisdom, and protection. So I hope you enjoy our next piece called the Rowan Tree. Very beautiful.
Thank you.
these kids have had the year they've had, but that they sound like they do tonight, to me is really amazing. And I want to thank the clinicians who have worked with these kids, these instructors. They really have done a superb job in teaching them how to get good tone production and how to put plenty of air through the instrument and how the enthusiasm of playing. They've played themselves. They've been able to demonstrate what it should sound like, and they've done a really magnificent job and have made my job a whole lot easier. Plus, it's fun to have them up here on the stage. Some of the older ones. They're not that old. I'm probably the oldest person up here. Anyway, the next piece that we're going to play is called The Tempest. And The Tempest is simply a storm. And I think that you, when you hear this, you'll hear the storm starting to brew up, and then it really unleashes lots of power and energy. So I hope you enjoy this next one called The Tempest by Robert W. Smith. Thank you. having me here for Dr. Andy Pettis, my dear friend from Anderson University, who gave them the idea to bring me here. And if you are, how many parents, how many of you here played an instrument when you were in school? Oh, that's a lot. The Oconee Winds would like to see you. Okay? I'm sure that they would be happy to take new blood. And, you know, from what I can tell, based on the talent level of people that I've heard from this group, it's pretty amazing. You know, you have a real jewel right here in your county. And even if you don't participate in a concert, coming to a concert and supporting them, I know would be greatly appreciated. Thank you once again to them, to Dr. Pettis, and to these fabulous, fabulous students. You all as parents have evidently done something really, really well because there's something else. Thank you so much, and I hope you enjoy our Disney piece. Thank you.
Thank you.
once again for participating in this year's summer camp. Thank you for investing in your children's musical future. Since most of you, or many of you, are musicians, you know how important it is to carry some of these memories and skills well into your adulthood, and we thank you for investing in your children like that. One more time, I would like to recognize our instructors, if they would all please stand. Thank you for coming.